shade of Auckland's iconic One Tree Hill, just a 15-minute drive from the city centre. A unique mix of shopping, port activity, and light industrial action. It has a thriving population, with a third of its numbers derived from people born outside of New Zealand. I'm from Japan, but have spent half my life living elsewhere. First in the US, and now here in New Zealand with my lovely wife and son. I think it gives me a very specific viewpoint from which I can truly see what this culturally rich area has to offer. So this time on Neighbourhood, I'm going to share a little bit of what's happening in Onehunga. We meet a young Russian artist who gains inspiration from a family heirloom.
This icon for me is connection to the roots that were there even before I was born.
Shell calzone made by a local Sicilian.
Food for the Italian culture is everything. It's what keeps us together.
We catch up with the Japanese potter whose modern works hark back to ancient tradition.
When I start tea ceremony, you can imagine so beautiful rows of instruments. I was crazy about tea ceremony.
And we are invited to join a very special book club.
La lengua española.
The Spanish language is very rich and also very descriptive. I love my language.
I'm Hiroshi Nakatsuji, and this here in Onehunga, my love for books is shared by Martha Alvarez from Uruguay. Her passion for the written word has led to her form a very special book club.
Cuando uno llega a un país que habla otro idioma.
When one arrives in a country where people speak another language, you realize that it's like a shock. And I'm not talking about the cultural shock. It's that shock that makes you realize that it's very hard, very difficult to say something if you don't speak the language. I did not speak English, and I was literally running out of Spanish speakers to talk to.
A desarrollar mi propia lengua.
Mi nombre es Mirta Álvarez.
My name is Mirta Álvarez, and I was born in the Republic of Uruguay in South America. The book club exists for the last 3 years, and it is a very special club. It's not what people tend to think about a book club. We are not reading all the same book or doing the same things. It's a very special one.
Y tratan de las tiranías y de los gobiernos.
The book club gathers once a month and consists of 13 members.
Somos 13 personas.
This is about people reading something and coming to the meeting and telling the rest of the group, like, oh, look what I read. It's so great. And then you'll say, well, maybe I like it, maybe I don't, maybe I want to read that. Or sometime, at some point you'll find something that you realize you should be reading.
I guess it's every person trying to bring their own perspective on different topics. So if we're, say, talking about a short story, but the short story was about some, in general, politics or the international economy, then that's a trigger for us to start talking about the whole world and how we perceive the world.
I've been here in New Zealand for 13 years, so I lost a bit of the contact of what is happening over there. So this group is really good for me, so I keep in touch for what is new, what new books are coming up, and what are they doing in the literature, in the Spanish culture. So that's really good.
The experience of a book is just totally different. It's a new world, this experience, you know, it's just so much learning. So since, yeah, I was a child, I really loved the smell and the touching of the books. Reading them, touching them. Yeah!
Marisol.
The Spanish language is very rich and also very descriptive. For example, sometimes I'm looking for the word to describe something and I find a lot of synonyms. because we have a lot of synonyms for the same thing. It's a very rich, descriptive language. I love my language.
También lo tengo, sí, lo tengo en la biblioteca. Sí, 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 sí.
The
Auckland Latin American community has been working in Auckland for over 20 years, and they have several projects to help the community. I decided to start a Spanish library in Auckland. The library started with 280 books that were donated by the community. And at the inauguration of the library, we had 100 people.
La literatura,
literature, books, music, everything helps to get over the initial shock in order to integrate to a country. In a new country, you want to give as well as receive. And part of the integration to the New Zealand culture is also giving your own culture. After 8 years in New Zealand, I got used to the Anglo-Saxon culture. I do feel part of this country of New Zealand. What I feel is that I have so much that I can give to the country.
Thank you, New Zealand. You have a beautiful country. It's a people generous, people friendly, and beautiful nature. Thank you for all.